This is SPX Graphics Controller. GC is a graphics control client for Kaspersky CG and streaming applications. Here I have a local instance running on my PC, and this is the user interface of the application running in a browser. In my current setup, I just have one Kaspersky CG connected. See, here is the green light for that one. And there's another one which is not connected at the moment. You can have several servers connected in the configuration. This one is the output from Kaspersky CG. Also, I have a streaming application connected for doing a live stream to the web, to Facebook, YouTube, Twitch and so on. In this case I'm using OBS or Open Broadcast Software. This is the output from OBS. In my GC, I have a demo rundown open which has a couple of templates. I can move these around, I can double click to open them, I can make changes and I can save them. And then I can play those out using either a keyboard shortcut like I'm doing right now, or I can click these buttons to trigger these events. You can have several layers on screen at once. And the ones which are rendering, they have this green arrow showing that this one is on air. These controls below the preview window are plugins, which can be used to add functionality to the application. So in my demo here, for instance, I have a bumper. So it can trigger this bumper, which happens to be a Lottie animation. And also I can assign specific commands to this one. For instance, I can trigger a wipe in Kaspersky CG, so it is actually triggering a video clip inside Kaspersky CG, and I can choose which video I want to trigger from here, just as an example. And this one is a combo button, so it actually does several things at once. So it will take out all these layers and it's going to trigger a bumper which is going to cover everything. Now let's install GC from scratch to my PC here locally. So the application is available on GitHub, and here on this page you can go to pre-built packages and you can choose the zip package for your operating system. It is also available as a source code, so if you are a developer and you want to know how it runs, and so you can run it through a Node.js server. But now let's download the Windows package for my PC here. So now it has been downloaded. I'm going to just move this package into the folder where I want to run this application. I'm going to unzip it here. And I'm going to remove the zip file since it's not needed anymore. So now if I double click on this exe file to run the application, we will see a pop-up showing about networks. I'm going to allow it. And here we have the URL for the user interface. So let's open this one in a browser. And first time when you run the application, you are going to be shown this screen which is asking for the login policy. I'm going to make it simple for us and I'm just going to choose no, I don't want to use username and password in this installation on my home PC. And this is the welcome page. I'm just going to go into projects, and here I have the list of projects. I can create a new one. My first project. And I'm in my project settings. I'm going to import a single template just so we can see the functionality of the application. So let's take this one. So now I have that selected. These are the settings for that template. Let's go to my project and add a rundown. My first rundown. Now I'm in the controller and I can assign this single template which I have added to my project. I can add it to the playlist and I can take it out, and here it runs. And if we take a look at the OBS output and the Kaspersky CG output, we can see that we have the same graphic up there. And we can have another copy of this one. Let's change the content to something else. and let's choose a different icon, and let's take this one, and here we can see the graphic playing out. GC has settings in two different places. One is global settings or configurations for the app. For instance, we can change the language. This can be customized, so you can add your own language. There's the logging level and folder locations and these kind of generic settings. And also here we can define our Casper CG servers. Another place where we can access settings are per project. So if I go into my first project here, I have these project settings. And in project settings, I can assign templates to this specific project. And I can also add extra functionality to this specific project by adding a plugin to it. So I have three options available at the moment: button, toggle button, and selection dropdown. And let's choose all of these. So we should have, now when we go into our actual project, we should have these demo buttons available here. So if I click on this one, it's just gonna give us a little pop-up window saying that that worked. Another one is showing that the button turned red, so it means the function is active. And now we can stop the function by clicking on it again, and we can run some demo sounds.
Yes!
If you have any questions regarding graphics controller, template customizations, or additional integrations or functionality, please get in touch. Thank you.